That maqam and status Allah gave him. That when the time for hijrat came, I'm digressing. During the Khilafat of Umar radiallahu ta'ala, a mashura was held among Sahaba. That Islam has spread far and wide. The need was felt among Sahaba that a calendar should be established. An Islamic calendar. The issue was raised, where must the calendar start from? What was the turning point in the history of Islam on the basis of which the calendar of the Muslim Ummah can start? Different rise, different opinions came from Sahaba. Someone said Maulid al-Nabi, the birth of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Someone said Fateh Badr, the conquest of Badr. Someone said Fateh Makkah, the conquest of Makkah. Ali radiallahu anhu remained silent. Finally, Umar radiallahu anhu turned to him that, Ali, what is your opinion? What was the turning point? What was the basis on which the calendar should start? Ali radiallahu anhu gives his opinion. He says, Hijrat. Hijrat. Ayyul imani afdal. Ayyul imani afdal. This question was put in Darbar al-Risalat of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. What is the height of iman? What is the pinnacle of iman? What is the highest point of iman? Ayyul imani afdal. What did my Nabi say? Al-hijra. Al-hijra. To leave one's home. To leave one's family. To leave one's marghub and beloved things for the sake of Allah. To strive in the path of Allah. Every Nabi of Allah. From Adam alayhi salam to Janabi Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi salam. Hijrat was their sunnah. Nabi sallallahu alayhi salam himself. In that 10-year period in Madinah Munawwara. How many times he strove in the path of Allah? Every sahabi was put on this amal. First was the ultimate hijrat. Sahaba of Makkah left their homes, left their families, left their businesses. Gave up everything for Allah for the sake of hidayat for this ummah. So that this deen could come alive. That call of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in Mina. 10 to 10, person to person. Gali to gali, ali to ali. May yuhini, may yansuruni, hatta ubaligha risalata rabbi. Who will shelter me? Who will become my nasir and my helper? For what? So that I can make tabligh of this deen. So that I can make tabligh of this deen. What was happening? He was for hijrat. Which area will accept me? Will accept me so that he can become the base by which Islam will spread to the four corners of the world. We know the history, we're not going into the details. Time is limited. Today this question is being asked. The way it comes must leave your home, leave your families. Where is this 3 days, 40 days, 4 months? Where is all this coming from? You won't find it in the Daily News or in the Star. You won't find it in some magazine. Where it comes, we are not looking. Where it comes, we are not looking. This was the sunnah of every Nabi of Allah. لَن تَنَالُوا الْبِرَّ حَتَّى تُنْفِقُوا مِمَّا تُحِبُّونَ. Allah says, you will never attain kamal-e qurb. You will never attain the true closeness of Allah until you don't sacrifice for Allah's sake that which you love. Sacrifice for the sake of Allah, your beloved, your marghub. And Allah will give you His love, His ta'alluq. Ali radiallahu anhu says, Hijra. Why? Because this ummah was selected and chosen by Allah. This is not an ordinary ummah. This ummah was given the amal of Anbiya alayhi salatu was salam. Dawud alayhi salam, more than 1,000 years before this ummah could come into existence. Allah addresses him, Ya Dawud, Inni faddaltu ummata Muhammad ala al-umami kulliha, wa sanantu lahum al-sunan, allati sanantuha ala al-anbiya, wa aftaradtu alayhim al-farayid, allati aftaradtuha ala al-anbiya, hatta ya'tuni yawm al-qiyama, wa nuruhum mithlu nuri al-anbiya. And oh Dawood, I gave fazilat, distinction, honor, superiority to the ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam over every other ummah. I made sunnat upon them, sunnat of anbiya. I made farz upon them, fariza of anbiya. What was the sunnat of anbiya? What was the fariza of anbiya? Dawat! This dard and pain for humanity. That call of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. La nabiyya ba'di wa la ummata ba'da ummati. No nabi to come after me. No ummah to come after this ummah. So this responsibility of da'wah. this dard, this pain, this cry of Anbiya alayhi salatu wasalam, this cry of Muhammad Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam was handed over to this ummah. Anbiya's sunnat was made sunnat for this ummah. Anbiya's farida was made farz for this ummah. Hatta ya'tuni yawm al-qiyamah wa nuruhum mithlu nur al-anbiya. Allah says to Dawud alayhi salam, if they will fulfill this, they will come before me on the day of judgment and I will give them nur like the nur of the anbiya. أوحى الله تعالى إلى موسى نبي بني إسرائيل أن في أمة محمد لرجال ينادون على كل شرف وواد بشهادة أن لا إله إلا الله. Allah sends wahi to Musa عليه السلام that in the Ummah of Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم they are men. What is their شعار? What is their symbol? How will you recognize them? How will you recognize this Ummah? You will find them on every high ground, every low ground, every gully, every alley. What will they be doing? They will be raising the pukar and the call of La ilaha illallah. Yunadun bi shahadati an la ilaha illallah. They will be giving da'wah to the greatness of Allah. Fajazawhum jazawul anbiya. Allah says to Musa alayhi salam, I will reward them like anbiya were rewarded. Look at the tense of Quran. When Allah speaks of anbiya, what expression Allah uses in the Quran? Amongst the expressions, istafa, ikhtar, one expression is ijtiba. وَكَذَلِكَ يَجْتَبِيكَ رَبُّكَ وَكَذَلِكَ يَجْتَبِيكَ رَبُّكَ يُوسف عليه السلام. ثُمَّ اجْتَبَاهُ رَبُّهُ فَتَابَ عَلَيْهِ وَهَدَى آدم عليه السلام. فَاجْتَبَاهُ وَهَدَاهُ إِلَى صِرَاطٍ مُسْتَقِيمٍ يُونُس عليه السلام. اجتباهُ وهداهُ إبراهيم عليه السلام. وكذلك يجتبيك ربك يوسف عليه السلام. ثم اجتباهُ ربه فتاب عليه وهدى آدم عليه السلام. فاجتباهُ ربه فجعله من الصالحين يونس عليه السلام. اجتباهُ وهداهُ إلى صراط مستقيم إبراهيم عليه السلام. اجتبيناهم وهديناهم all the Anbiya alayhim as-salatu was-salam. And for the Ummat of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, وَجَاهِدُوا فِي اللَّهِ حَقَّ جِهَادِ هُوَ اجْتَبَاكُمْ. Same expression that was used for Anbiya alayhim as-salatu was-salam is used for this Ummat. And look at the manner in which they fulfill the haqq of it. Simple comparison. The Ummat of Musa alayhi salam, 40 years the sohbat of two Nabis. Yet when they came, water in front, army of Firaun behind, what happened? قَالَ أَصْحَابُ مُسَىٰ إِنَّا لَمُدْرَكُونَ. The Bani Israel, the companions of Musa alayhi salam said, oh Musa, we are destroyed. The subtle nuance contained in this expression, inna lamudrakun, is indirectly they were blaming Musa alayhi salam. You destroyed us. You put us in this situation. What was the response of Musa alayhi salam? Kalla. Kalla. The subtle nuance contained in this, kalla, is I knew you would say that. Inna ma'ya rabbi sayahdeen. My Allah is with me. Allah will show us the way. 40 years the sohbat of two Nabis and this was the reaction. No concern for Musa alayhi salam. No concern for the safety of Harun alayhi salam. Concern only for themselves. This ummat, when the occasion of hijrat comes, what was this? This was a journey fraught with danger. An announcement had been made, 100 camel prize for the one who brings the head of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, na'uzu billah. Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala anhu, long in advance, he prepares two camels, waiting in anticipation, desiring that he should accompany Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in hijrah. Aisha radiallahu anha is the narrator of the incident. Our mother, what does she say? She was a young girl at that time. She said, normally Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam would come to the home of Abu Bakr, either in the morning or in the evening. Today he came in the middle of the day. It was not a normal time. Quietly he enters the home. Secrecy, why there was danger in every direction. He says to Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala anhu, that, oh Abu Bakr, Allah has given permission for hijrat. This was a death sentence. 100 camel's head, prize on his head, swords in every direction. What does Abu Bakr say? As-suhba ya Rasulullah. As-Suhba, Ya Rasulallah. O Nabi of Allah, will you grant me permission to be your companion in Hijrat? Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam says, yes, Abu Bakr, you will be my companion. Look at the manner in which Aisha radiallahu anha describes the such intelligence Allah gave her. She says, مَا شَعَرْتُ قَدْتُ أَنَّ أَحَدًا قَبْلَ ذَلِكَ الْيَوْمِ يَبْكِي مِنَ الْفَرَحِ حَتَّى رَأَيْتُ يَوْمَئِذٍ أَبَا بَكْرٍ يَبْكِي. She says, I had heard that it was possible for someone to cry out of happiness. I doubted. I heard about it. I didn't see the reality of it. Until that day, when Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam told my father that you are going to be my companion in Hijrat, Abu Bakr started crying out of happiness. Medina to the north, Ghar Esod to the south. In the dead of night, crawling on fingertips, in order to throw the trackers off, the Mubarak hands and feet of Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam started bleeding. According to the riwayat of Ibn Abi Mulaika, when they came to the mountain, Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam couldn't climb. His hands and feet were bleeding profusely. Abu Bakr lifts the Rasul of Allah on his back, climbs up the face of the mountain till he comes to the entrance of the cave. It is the 27th of Safar. The month is September, 27th of Safar. According to the lunar month, the latter part, so it was pitch black, no moonlight. Abu Bakr himself says to Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, Ya Rasulullah, you wait here. Let me see if there's anything dangerous in the cave. He enters himself, finds a lot of holes, is afraid there is something that might harm the Nabi of Allah. Takes off his amama, tears it, fills the holes. Still there are holes, takes off his kurta, tears it, fills those holes. Still there is one hole, he places his own foot against that hole. Then, marhaba ya Rasulullah, O Nabi of Allah, now you may enter. Nabi Sallam enters the cave, the night passes, as the light enters the next day. Abu Bakr, what happened to your amama? What happened to your kurta? Abu Bakr says, Ya Rasulullah, there were holes, I was afraid. There was something that may harm you. I toyed to fill up the holes. Tears enter the eyes of Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Looks to the heavens, O Allah, I am happy with Abu Bakr. You also become happy with Abu Bakr and make Abu Bakr my companion in Jannah. No sooner he says this, Jibril comes, Ya Rasulullah, Allah is happy with Abu Bakr and Allah has made Abu Bakr your companion in Jannah. The next day, despite all the measures, the trackers were so intelligent that time, were so astute at their profession, that the army, the Jamaat of Quraysh comes right up till the door of the cave. At that time, Abu Bakr is worried. Abu Bakr is worried. Quran encapsulates in its internal azali language this entire incident. When Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam consoles Abu Bakr, what does he say to him? La tahzan. La tahzan. Inna Allah ma'ana. Thani athnain. Idh huma fil ghar. Idh yaqul li sahibihi. La tahzan. Inna Allah ma'ana. The second of the two, when they were in the cave, when the one said to his companion, La tahzan. Banu Israel, qala ashabu Musa, inna lamudrakun. Not worried about themselves. If Abu Bakr's concern was for himself, Quran would not have said la tahzan. Quran would have said la takhaf. Abu Bakr, do not fear for your life. Allah is with us. Quran does not say la takhaf, la tahzan. Abu Bakr, do not grieve or worry about your Nabi. Allah is with us. Huwajtabakum. This ummah was selected, chosen by Allah. Sahaba understood the reality of this. The same Abu Bakr, one occasion, Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam enters the masjid. Right hand side Abu Bakr, left hand side Umar. Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam holds both their hands, raises it up and says, Hakada nuhsharu yawm al-qiyamah. Exactly like this, Allah will raise us on the day of judgment. Basharat upon basharat upon basharat. Glad tidings upon glad tidings. Yet what does Abu Bakr say? Ya laytani kuntu shajaratan tu'adat. Ya layta ummi lam talidin. He says, if only my mother had not given birth to me. If only I was a blade of.
God. If only I was a blade of grass. Some animal ate me up and I would not have to stand in Allah's court. These were personalities. They were given the glad tidings of Jannat in this world. Yet such was the concern, such was the dard, such was the pain, such was the level of qurbani. They gave qurbani and then qurbani and then qurbani. They never became complacent. Behind this was the example of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The dard, the cry, the concern of Muhammad Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The clock of our life is ticking, my respected brothers. This dunya is going, that qabr is coming closer and closer. What did my Nabi say? Israfil has already taken the trumpet into his mouth. Kaifa an'am? What justification is there in chasing behind this dunya when Israfil has already taken the trumpet? He's waiting. His gaze is locked on the arsh of Allah. Yantadir an yumar fa yanfukh. Waiting for the command of Allah and then he will blow. What will happen? إِذَا السَّمَاءُ انْفَطَرَتْ وَإِذَا الْكَوَاكِبُ انْتَثَرَتْ وَإِذَا الْبِحَارُ فُجِّرَتْ وَإِذَا الْقُبُورُ بُعْثِرَتْ إِذَا الشَّمْسُ كُوِّرَتْ وَإِذَا النُّجُومُ انْكَدَرَتْ وَإِذَا الْجِبَالُ سُيِّرَتْ وَإِذَا الْعِشَارُ عُطِّلَتْ وَإِذَا الْوُحُوشُ حُشِرَتْ وَإِذَا الْبِحَارُ سُجِّرَتْ وَإِذَا النُّفُوسُ زُوِّجَتْ وَإِذَا الْمَوْءُودَةُ سُئِلَتْ بِأَيِّ ذَنْبٍ قُتِلَتْ يَسْأَلُونَكَ عَنِ الْجِبَالِ فَقُلْ يَنْسِفُهَا رَبِّي نَسْفًا فَيَذَرُهَا قَاعًا صَفْصَفًا لَا تَرَى فيها عوجا ولا أمتا. القارعة ما القارعة؟ ما أدراك ما القارعة؟ الحاقة ما الحاقة؟ وما أدراك ما الحاقة؟ يوم تشقق السماء بالغمام ونزل الملائكة تنزيلا. اتقوا ربكم إن زلزلة الساعة شيء عظيم. يوم ترونها تذهل كل مرضعة عما أرضعت وتضع كل ذات حمل حملها وترى الناس سكارى وما هم بسكارى ولكن عذاب الله شديد. How many places in the Quran Allah describes? The sun will split, the moon, the sun will die, the earth will die, the skies will die, the mountains will die, every creation of Allah will die. Who created this dunya, before creating it, already decided, وَإِنَّا لَجَاعِلُونَ مَا عَلَيْهَا سَعِيدًا جُرُزًا. We will obliterate and destroy everything in existence. Everything will be destroyed. Everything will be destroyed. One Allah alone will remain. One Allah alone will remain. Wallah, my respected brothers, the entire maqsad and object of this da'wah is to make the qibla and direction of this heart Allah. Give this da'wah towards the greatness of Allah. The giver is Allah. The maker is Allah. The controller is Allah. The one who raises up is Allah. The one who brings down is Allah. The one who gives health is Allah. The one who gives sickness is Allah. The one who gives life is Allah. The one who gives death is Allah. The one who gives wealth is Allah. The one who gives poverty is Allah. Every halat, every condition, from wherever, however, in whatever shape, whatever form, whatever color, whatever appearances, nothing is happening from anywhere. One Allah alone is doing. Jo la kaha, wo la hua, wo la bi usme la hua, juz la hua, kul la hua, phir kya hua? Allah hua, Allah hua, Allah hua. Haramun ala qalb, haramun ala qalb, an yadkhulahu an-nur wa fihi shay'un mimma yakrahu Allah. Ulama say it is haram, impossible. Impossible, inconceivable that the nur of Allah's marifat will enter a heart in which there is ghairullah. This ghairullah has to come out. Kul hadihi sabili. Kul hadihi sabili. Ay maqsadu hayati. Ay wazifu hayati. Ay tariqu hayati. Tell them, my beloved, this is my way. This is my road. This is my maqsad. This is my goal. This is my way of life. What? Ad'u ila Allah, ad'u ila Allah, ad'u ila Allah, to give da'wah towards Allah's greatness. Invite towards Allah, ala basiratin, with conviction, ana wa man ittaba'ani, ay wa man amana bi, myself and everyone who brought iman upon me. Everyone who brought iman upon me, da'wah ila Allah is their maqsad, is their wazifa, is their way of life. That day is coming, my respected brothers. How many places in the Quran? Allahu Akbar, this word. In Arabic language, day is what? Yom. Allah reminds us again and again and again. Yomul Fasl. Yomul Jaza. Yomul Khusran. Yomul Fawzan. Yomul Jannah. Yomul Nar. Yomul Hasra. Yomul Nadama. Yomul Tawmatul Kubra. Yomul Taghabun.
How many places? يوم 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 لا يوم يأتي لا تكلم نفس إلا بإذني. يوم يقوم الروح والملائكة صفا لا يتكلمون. خشعت الأصوات. There will be total complete silence. أنذر الناس يوم يأتيهم العذاب. مالك يوم الدين. ذلك يوم مشهود. إن يوم الفصل كان ميقاتا. إن يوم الفصل ميقاتهم أجمعين. A day is coming. A day is coming. A day is coming. ولقد جئتمونا فرادا كما خلقناكم أول مرة وتركتم ما خولناكم وراء ظهوركم. Allah will gather every one of you. We will resurrect every one of you. وحشرناهم فلم نغادر منهم أحدا. لقد أحصاهم وعدهم عدا. Everyone without exception will be resurrected, will have to stand in Allah's court, will have to stand before Allah, will have to give account for the life of this world. That day is coming. It is a reality. Inescapable reality. Yom, yom, yom. Such a day. In this world, when you are in a problem, you can hide. What does Allah say? La takhfa minkum khafiya. No way to hide that day. This world, you run away. There in al-mafar, where are you going to run? This world, maybe you got some bucks. Buy your way out of the problem. Create some sort of opposition to your difficulty. That day, anfudhu, la tanfudhuna illa bi sultan. How are you going to oppose? No opposition, the day of justice. وَجَاءَ رَبُّكَ وَالْمَلَكُ صَفًّا صَفًّا أُزْلِفَتِ الْجَنَّةُ لِلْمُتَّقِينَ بُرِّزَتِ الْجَحِيمُ لِلْغَاوِينَ وَنَضَعُ الْمَوَازِينَ الْقِسْطَ فَلَا تُظْلَمُ نَفْسٌ شَيْئًا. The scales of justice will be set up on that day. Each one will have to stand in Allah's court. Will have to stand in front of Allah. We are worried about service delivery. We worried about electricity. We worried about running water. We worried about sanitation. We worried about everything else. What about the worry when we will have to stand in front of Allah? يوم يقوم الناس لرب العالمين. What about that day? What about that concern? That muazzin 5 times every day. Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. That call reminding us. Present yourself in this court. Present yourself in this court. What does Ibn al-Qayyim rahimullah said? What did he say? Lil-abdi, bayna yaday Allahi mawqifan. Mawqifun bayna yadayhi fi salatihi. Wa mawqifun bayna yadayhi yawma liqai rabbihi. Faman qama bihaqqi al-mawqif al-awwal, huwin alayhi al-mawqif al-akhir. Wa man istahana bihada al-mawqif, ولم يوفي حقه شدد عليه ذلك الموقف. Allah give us the understanding. He says everyone, there are two opportunities when you will stand in Allah's court. The one is 5 times every day when that call is made. The salah, you are presenting yourself in the court of Allah. He says the second standing is on the day of judgment when you will have to stand in Allah's court. What does Ibn al-Qayyim say? He says the one who will fulfill the haqq of this first standing, Allah will make the second standing easy for him. وَمَنْ إِسْتَهَانَ بِهَذَا الْمَوْقِفِ وَلَمْ يُوَفِّ حَقَّهُ. If you will make mazak of this standing, treat it lightly. Like we see, Jummah Salah Masjid is full, next Salah Masjid is empty. Fajr Salah Masjid is empty. How many Muslim homes? How many Muslim homes those masoom children only get up with the rising of the sun? What are the seeds that we are planting? What is the tomorrow of our children? What preparation for akhirat are we giving them? What is the legacy that we are leaving behind? He says, if you will treat this first standing lightly, Allah protect us, Allah forgive us, Allah make it easy for us. He says, the second standing will become difficult. شُدِّدْ عَلَيْهِ ذَلِكَ الْمُوْقِ. On that day, there will be those who have pleased Allah. فَأَمَّا مَنْ أُوْتِيَ كِتَابَهُ بِيَمِينِهِ فَأَمَّا مَنْ أُوْتِيَ كِتَابَهُ بِيَمِينِهِ. Quran says there will be those who will get their book of deeds in the right hand. فَيَقُولُ هَا أُمُقْرَوُ كِتَابِيَهِ. إني ظننت أني ملاق حسابيا، فهو في عيشة راضية في جنة عالية قطوفها دانية، كلوا واشربوا هنيئا بما أسلفتم في الأيام الخالية. اللهم اجعلنا منهم. Some will get the book of deeds in the right hand. How? Come, come. Excited, happy. Come, come. Read my book. Read my book. I had yakin in this day. I prepared for it. Such a jannat Allah has prepared. They said the lowest jannat. In fact, very often I mention this, to use this term low for jannat is inappropriate. But just translating the riwayat, inna adana ahlil jannati manzila. Rasulullah SAW said the lowest ranking jannati. Normally when there's a big event to take place, they put red carpet. They call it red carpet ceremony. The more prominent the event, the more longer carpet. How much carpet are they going to put? 10 meters, 15 meters? It is said for the istiqbal, for the welcoming reception of the last person to enter Jannah, the lowest Jannati, the carpet that will be stretched out will be 40 years long. Flanked on either side by 80,000 servants. إِذَا رَأَيْتَهُمْ حَسِبْتَهُمْ لُؤْلُؤًا مَنْثُورًا. The servants, leave anything else. The servants, Allah says, will look like scattered pearls. Quran describes the servants, يَطُوفُ عَلَيْهِمْ وِلْدَانٌ مُخَلَّدُونَ بِأَكْوَابُ وَأَبَارِيقُ وَكَأْسٍ مِّن مَعِينٌ. Allah uses the word يَطُوف, تَوَاف. The dunya, when you got a servant working for you, when you're looking at him, he's busy. Turn your back, he relaxes. Why are you not looking now? Jannah, the servants won't be like that. They'll be making tawaf all the time, moving all the time. Sometimes bringing kebab, sometimes bringing fish, sometimes bringing juice, sometimes bringing wine, sometimes bringing honey. This dish, that dish, all the time, all the time. Sayyidana, ya Maulana, ya Sayyidi. Do you wish this? Do you wish this? Do you wish this? 80,000 servants for the lowest jannati. A dastarkhan will be laid out. On that dastarkhan will be 80,000 different types of food. Not like the food of dunya. How much can you eat in dunya? You go to one function, they give you gajar halwa and soji starter. Appetizer. Then the main course. Nowadays the functions are such, Allah forgive us. 7-course and 8-course meals. By the time the 5th or 6th course is reached, people want to go home. They're looking for Eno, they're looking for indigestion tablets, got this problem, the heartburn. Somebody bring one hot plate of biryani, you can eat. Bring the second plate, maybe, got a good appetite, you can eat. Third plate, bye. No more taste in it. You get exceptions. There was one person, he was traveling, he came to one town. So there was a generous person in that town, he saw he's a stranger, so he invited him home. He said, whatever little I have, I'll present it to you. Made the person sit in the dastarkhan. Went and fetched the hot curry, put in front of him, went to fetch roti. By the time he came back with the roti, the curry was finished. So he left the roti and went back for more curry. Came back with the curry, the roti was finished. So like this, this person started making Safa Marwas, Sa'i, up and down, up and down. So all his food, all his curry, all his roti, everything got finished. He got finished also. Finally, that man got satisfied. So he started a conversation with him. By where are you going? He said, I'm going to a certain town. Why? He said, I suffer from an illness. There's a very good doctor there. What do you suffer from? He said, I suffer from lack of appetite. So he said, brother, do me one favor. On your return journey, please don't pass this town. Use another road. Generally, you get exceptions to the rule. But how much can a person eat? The food of Jannat will not be like the food of dunya. The food of Jannat is such. It comes in the riwayat, يَجِدُ فِي آخِرِ لُقْمَةٍ مِّنْهَا لَذَّةً لَمْ يَجِدْ قَبْلَهَا. This person will experience in the 80,000th morsel that lazzat and ecstasy which he did not experience before that. Better and better and better and better. Such a jannat. Obviously, it's not only eating. After eating, what happens? What is the next stage? The curtain will drop. And in front of him will be the Hoor of Jannat. وَحُورٌ عِينٌ كَأَمْثَالِ اللُّؤْلُؤِ الْمَكْنُونَ جَزَاءً بِمَا كَانُوا يَعْمَلُونَ. عربا أترابا، كواعب أترابا، كأنهن بيض مكنون، كأنهن الياقوت والمرجان، كأمثال اللؤلؤ المكنون. What descriptions Allah gives in the Quran. These women have such beauty, such beauty. من أصابع رجليها إلى ركبتيها من الزعفران. From her toenail till her knee will be made out of saffron. من ركبتيها إلى ثدييها من المسك الخالص. From the knee till the chest out of pure musk. من ثدييها إلى عنقها من الأمبر الأشهل. From the chest to the neck out of pure amber. من عنقها إلى رأسها من الكافور الأبيض. From the neck to the top of the head out of pure camphor. خلقت من سلالة المسك والعنبر والزعفران والكافور. She will be created not from earth, wind, sand and water, but from the quintessence of musk, amber, camphor and saffron. نور وجهها من نور الله تعالى. Her face will not be from cosmetics. Will not be from chemicals. No. Not be from going beauty parlor. The noor of her face will be from the noor of Allah. Her hair will be such from the top of the head it will reach right down till the heels. One strand of that hair, Rasulullah said, if it is brought into the world, the whole world will become fragrant. Her hair will be interspersed with emeralds, diamonds, rubies and sapphires. The value of one of those pearls is more than the combined jewelry of this entire world. Such beauty these women have. كلما نظر إليها كل نظر إليها ازدادت في عينه سبعين ضعفا حسنا وجمالا. Each time he looks at her, looks away, when he looks back, she will have become 70 times more beautiful. يتلذذ من رؤيتها يتلذذ من رؤيتها. He will get lazzat just looking at her. What will her height be? 130 foot tall. 130 foot tall is the height of the woman of Jannat. Don't get worried, you won't need a ladder. Qamatu Adam, that was the height of Adam alayhi salam. Humanity first, Adam alayhi salam was 130 foot tall. As the ages passed, people got shorter and shorter and shorter and shorter. Now it's 5 or 6 feet. They say dynamite comes in small packages. May even go shorter, Allah knows best. Once he gave one latifa, he says there was this farmer, he told his laborer, you know what, I want you to malish oil my horse. So the farmer went away, the laborer, what he did, boss is not around, not looking, so he tied the horse up and went to sleep. One thief came, stole the horse and ran away. Now when he wakes up, the horse is missing, he's worried. When the boss comes, you are supposed to be oiling the horse. How did this horse get stolen? Where the horse went? So quickly to save his skin, he found one rabbit. And he started malishing the rabbit. So when the farmer came, he said, where's my horse? He said, there's your horse. He said, what's wrong with you? That's not... He said, no, I was malishing it. It got shorter and shorter and shorter and I turned into a rabbit. So like that, humanity, thousands and thousands of years got shorter and shorter. But in Jannat, when the book of deeds come in the right hand, immediately, Qamatu Adam, the height of Adam alayhi salam, 130 foot tall. Husnu Yusuf, the beauty of Yusuf alayhi salam. Qalbu Ayyub, the heart of Ayyub alayhi salam. Miladu Isa, the age of Isa alayhi salam. Wa khuluku Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And the akhlaq and character of Muhammad Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The women of Jannat coming back. Such beauty. Yadhallu yandhuru ilayha sab'eena aaman. Allahu Akbar, the first gaze, such beauty Allah has given this woman, that the male of Jannat will stare at her transfixed for 70 years. 70 years, the woman of dunya, your wife, you look at her 2-3 minutes, what happens? What's wrong with you? Why are you staring? Look somewhere else. 70 years transfixed. لو بسقت بسقه في سبعه ابحر لمزجت الماء من عقوبه فمها من عذوبه فمها. And according to the poem of Ibn al-Qayyim, لكان احلى من العسل. There's no saliva in Jannah, but if this woman had to force herself, get a few droplets of saliva, And it had to come into this dunya. Then the waters of the seven oceans of the world will become sweeter than honey. If the Miss Universe, listen to this, my respect. If the Miss Universe of this dunya has to spit in your jar of honey, you'll throw it away. The women of Jannah, if she had to spit, the waters of the oceans will become sweeter than honey. Such women, and the woman of Iman of this dunya, the woman of Iman of this dunya, Allah will give her 70,000 times more beauty than the woman of Jannah. Such a Jannah. Such a Jannah. My Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam saw this Jannah. He saw Jannah. He saw Jahannam. Such was the dard. Such was the pain. Such was the cry. Such was the concern in the heart of Rasul Pak Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. He's sitting in Medina Munawara. A janazah is going past. Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam starts crying. Sahaba say to him, Ya Rasulullah, alaysat yahudiyya? Is that not the janazah of a Jew? Is that not the janazah of a Jew? Is that not the janazah of a Jew? Why are you crying? What is his response? He says, alaysat nafsun tafallatat minni? Is it not another ummati of mine? Is it not another ummati of mine that I have lost that is going to Jahannam forever and ever? Such was the dard. Such was the cry. Such was the pain in the heart of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Such a Nabi Allah gave this ummat. Such a Nabi Allah gave this ummat. Allah does not get tired of praising Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam in the Quran. Even the limbs, the body parts of Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam are interspersed throughout the Quran. قَدْ نَرَى تَقَلُّبَ وَجْهِكَ The face of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. لا تحرك به لسانك, the tongue of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. لا تمدن عينيك, the eyes of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. لا تجعل يدك, the hand of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. مغلولة إلى عنقك, the neck of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. ألم نشرح لك صدرك, the chest of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. الذي أنقذ ظهرك, the back of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. لا تحرك به لسانك, the tongue of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Somewhere the tongue, somewhere the face, somewhere the back. Somewhere the heart, somewhere the chest. And then Quran takes everything and brings it together. La amruk, by the qasam of the life of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Such a Nabi, the summat was given. Sahaba understood. Sahaba understood the meaning of ishq and muhabbat for Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. They understood the qada, the dictate. Of this legacy of the dard and pain of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Allah says, "Huwa jatabakum." You were chosen. You were chosen to make your day the day of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Your night, the night of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The dastan and legacy of qurbani of Rasul Pak sallallahu alaihi wasallam was in front of them. Day in, day out. Night in, night out. The cry, the dard, the pain of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam to such an extent that he himself says, لَقَدْ أُوذِيتُ فِي اللَّهِ مَا لَمْ يُوذَ أَحَدٌ أُخِفْتُ فِي اللَّهِ مَا لَمْ يَخَفْ أَحَدٌ وَلَقَدْ أَتَتْ عَلَيَّ ثَلَاثُونَ مِنْ بَيْنِ يَوْمِ وَلَيْلَةٍ مَا لِي وَلِبِلَالٍ مَا يَأْكُلُهُ كَبِدٌ إِلَّا مَا يُوَارِي بِهِ ابْنُ بِلَالٍ He said, I suffered in the way of Allah more than any other human being. I was made to fear more than any other human being. And they passed upon me and Sayyidina Bilal radiallahu ta'ala anhu 30 consecutive days. 1 month. And there wasn't sufficient for both of us to eat besides what Bilal radiallahu ta'ala anhu could conceal underneath his armpits. Such hunger, such faqa. In the valley of Abu Talib, the family of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam is boycotted. Food cut off. Water cut off, not given permission to trade, no source of livelihood, 3 years, 3 years. 3 years of boycott, to such an extent that it comes in the riwayat, the little baby, Fatima radiallahu anha, little baby, she grabs hold of the dress of her mother Khadija, Ummi al-Atash, Ummi al-Atash, Ummi al-Atash, oh my mother, I am thirsty, oh my mother, I am thirsty, oh my mother, I am thirsty. Harder than their own hunger, harder than their own faqa, was to see their children suffering like this. What must have passed through the heart of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam? What was the mindset behind the plot? They said, hand over Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and we will release you from boycott. Hand over Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Abu Talib at that time did not have iman. Yet, what was his reaction to this? Such was the devotion. He didn't even have the nur of iman in his heart. Yet such was the devotion to Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. That when this demand was made, hand over Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and we will restore your position and free you from boycott. Then he uttered a poem, what is referred to as Qasida Lami. 90 couplets, few of those couplets. كذبتم وبيت الله نفزا محمدا ولما نطاعن دونه ونناضلي ونسلمه حتى نصرى حوله ونذهل عن أبنائنا والحلائل وأبيض يستسقى الغمام بوجهه ثمال اليتامى عصمة للأرامل. What was the crux of this? The crux of this long poem was, if you want to reach Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, you will have to slaughter every one of us. You will have to create a mountain of our corpses before we will allow you to reach Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The misdaq and reality of this poem did not occur on that occasion. Sahaba of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, hu wajtabakum bani Israel, qala ashabu Musa inna lamudrakun. The Sahaba of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, they understood the dictate of hu wajtabakum. The ummah was selected and chosen by Allah to make its day the day of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, to make it night the night of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. They fulfilled the misdaq of this expression of Abu Talib in Uhud. There is pandemonium, there is confusion. The false rumor is spread that na'uzubillah, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam has been made shaheed. The rumor is spread that na'uzubillah, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam has been made shaheed. Utter panic, utter confusion in Sahaba. On that day, 70 of the Ansar of Medina had been made shaheed. Understand this, my respected brothers, 70 homes of Medina broken. 70 women widows, this, my respected brothers, 70 homes of Medina broken. 70 women widows, how many children orphans? Such a dastan and legacy of Qurbani given. The Kufar, the Quraysh of Makkah, they determined that this is our last chance, na'uzubillah, to take the life of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. In that confusion, this army of 1,000 marches towards Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Few sahaba remain. Abu Dujana radiallahu ta'ala anhu, Ka'b bin Malik, Bara bin Malik radiallahu ta'ala anhu, Ka'b bin Ajura radiallahu anhu, Ali radiallahu ta'ala anhu, Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu, Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu, Qatada bin Nu'man radiallahu ta'ala anhu, Talha radiallahu anhu, Zubair radiallahu ta'ala anhu, Ummi Ammara radiallahu anha, Abdullah and Habib bin Zayd radiallahu ta'ala anhum. In the books of history, 16 or 17 sahaba's names are mentioned. What do they do? Form a human shield around Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Amongst them was one woman, Ummi Ammara radiallahu anha. She was amongst those 72 that took the oath of allegiance in Aqaba in the 13th year of Nubuwwat, as a result of which the decision of Hijrat came. She was from Medina Munawwara. Her husband's name was Zayd radiallahu ta'ala anhu. She had two sons, Abdullah and Habib bin Zayd. On the occasion of Uhud, she addresses her two sons. When the whole army has marched against Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, she says to her two sons, that if one hair on the body of my Nabi is harmed, and you, my sons, are still standing, then the milk which I breastfed you with, I make it haram upon you. I will hold you responsible in the court of Allah. That same son, Habib bin Zayd, one of her two sons, many years later, Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam sends him as an emissary to Musaylama Kazzab. Musaylama had made false claim that he is a Nabi. Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam sends Habib bin Zayd to give him dawat. It is an international law that the emissary is not attacked. He doesn't come armed. That Malun Musaylama didn't even respect that much. When Habib bin Zayd comes in his court alone, solitary, defenseless, Musaylama captures him in front of his army. He orders that a saw should be brought. Places the saw on the right shoulder of Habib bin Zayd and says, do you bear witness that Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is the Nabi of Allah? He says, I bear witness that Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is the Nabi of Allah. Do you bear witness that I, Musaylama, am the Nabi of Allah? He says, I can't hear you. The right hand is cut off. Then the sword is placed on the left side. Do you bear witness that Muhammad is the messenger of Allah? He says, Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam says, yes. Do you bear witness that Salama and the messenger of Allah? He says, I can't hear you. Left hand is cut off. Right leg is cut off. Left leg is cut off. Then a saw is brought. And piece by piece, the body of the Sahabi is mutilated to such an extent that even the army of Musaylama started crying to see what he was doing. When the news of this comes back to the mother, they understood what was ishq and muhabbat for Rasulullah. They understood the value of this deen. They understood the pain and concern of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. What is her response? لِهَذَا الْيَوْمِ أَرْضَعْتُهُ وَعِنْدَ اللَّهِ احْتَسَبْتُهُ. I brought my son up so Allah accepts him for his deen. And by Allah I will get my reward. These were the women of that time. Cry tears of blood when you see the woman or the mother of today driving that fancy car with the Ray-Bans on. That young little girl, 9 or 10 years old, drops her off at the park with a skirt and frock to play. Ask yourself this question, my respected brothers. Who is going to teach the little masoom child that tomorrow you have to become the daughter of Fatima? Or tomorrow you have to become the daughter of Khadija? Or tomorrow you have to become the daughter of Aisha radiallahu anha? When these are the seeds that we are planting. Not for nothing our elders are telling us, bring alive the environment of deen in your homes. Not for nothing our elders are telling us, make effort on your masturat. Coming back to this incident, Sahaba form a human shield. Arrows raining down. Qatada bin Nu'man radiallahu anhu puts his face in front of the arrow. The arrow enters his eye socket. His eyeball disgorged, mutilated, drops out into his hand. Turns around, faces Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, crying. Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam sees this, looks to the heavens, and says, O Allah, the eye of Qatada was sacrificed in the protection of your Nabi. Takes the eyeball, mutilated eyeball in his hand. Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam places it back in the socket. And says, Allahumma ja'alha ahsana aynay. Oh Allah, make this the better of the two eyes. The son of Qatada bin Nu'man used to say, anabnu alladhi salat ala al-khaddi aynuhu, faruddat bi kaffi al-mustafa ahsanu al-raddi, fa'adat kama kanat li-awwali marratin, faya husna ma ayni, waya husna ma kaffi. He used to say, I am the son of the one whose eyeball rolled down his cheek. It was returned back to the socket by the hand of Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. It became better than that eye. What a beautiful hand, what a beautiful eye. Rain of arrows. Sahaba used their own bodies to protect the life of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Abdullah bin Qamiyah Mal'oon manages to find a gap, rushes through, takes his sword, brings it crushing down on the Mubarak shoulder of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Khudha wa ana ibn Qamiyah. Such is the force of the blow that the blood is pouring from the shoulder of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Utba bin Abi Waqqas Mal'oon. He sees Sahaba protecting Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam from arrows. What does this Mal'oon do? He picks up a rock, a boulder, flings it over this human wall, so that this huge boulder comes crushing down on the face of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Such is the might of the blow that Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam steps backwards. And as he steps backwards, he trips. And as he is falling, the side of his neck hits a jagged rock. Till the beloved of Allah falls down unconscious into a hole in the ground. Such is his condition. His face is full of blood. His hair is full of blood. His body full of blood. Full of dust, full of sand. Understand the value of this deen. Understand the value of the qurbani by which this deen reached us. Whose blood was spilled? From whom was qurbani taken? Whose face is in that condition? That face, which according to the tafsir of Imam Fakhruddin Razi, one of the tafsirs that are given, that face is the same face on which Allah takes qasam in His Quran. Wadduha, wadduha, by the qasam of the face of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. By the qasam of the black zulfa of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Today that same face is full of dust. That same face, it is said in the morning of the birth of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, There was one Jew running through Makkah, shouting to the people. Was a child born last night? They said, male child. They say, yes. Is his father alive? They said, no. They said, yes. He said, I'm not talking about that child. Was there a child born last night whose father is alive? Whose father is not alive? They said, yes. The grandson of Abdul Muttalib was born last night. This Jew says, take me to him. When he looks at the face, 2 or 3 hours old, looks at the face of the newborn baby Muhammad, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Allama Suyuti mentions this riwayat in his Khasais al-Kubra. What does the Jew say? Waylun li bani Israel. Laqad kharajat an-nubuwwatu minha. Wa ruhtum biha ya ma'shara Quraysh. Wallahi la yastawanna bikum satwatan. Yadharu amruha fi al-sharq wal-gharb. He says, halakat and destruction to the Bani Israel. Nubuwwat has left you forever. Mubarak to you, Quraysh. Mubarak to you, Quraysh. And then he points to this child. And he says, Wallah, the noor and light of this child will light up the entire world. Such a face. Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu says, Ma ra'aytu shay'an ahsana min Rasulillahi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Ka'anna shamsa tajri fi wajihi. Wa idha dhahika yatala'lahu fil judur. He says, I have never seen anything more beautiful than the face of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. It was as if the sun would shine from his face. And when Nabi would smile, the noor of his smile could be seen on the wall in front of him. Ali radiallahu anhu used to say, من رآه بديعة هابه ومن خالته معرفة أحبه يقول نعيته لم أرى قبله ولا بعده مثله. If someone all of a sudden came upon Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, would be overawed by his beauty. As they interacted with him, they would love him. The one who described him would say, before this and after this, I have never seen anything more beautiful than Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Hind bin Abi Hala would say, يَتَلَالَوْ وَجُهُ تَلَالُوَ الْقَمْرِ لَيْلَةَ الْبَدَرِ. The face of my Nabi would shine like the 14th full moon. Jabir bin Samara radiallahu anhu says, كُنْتُ فِي لَيْلَةِ أَدْحِيَانِ. It was a 14th full moon night. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was lying with his head in my lap. I looked to the moon, I looked to his face, I looked to the moon, I looked to his face. By the qasam of my Allah, the noor and effulgence of his face was more than the moon. Such a Nabi, such a Nabi. That same Mubarak face. He's lying in the dust. Sahaba overtaken with grief. After a little while, Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam regains consciousness. There's no words to describe the happiness of Sahaba. 70 Ansar have become shaheed. The beloved uncle of Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam shaheed. The beloved Nabi of Allah bleeding in this condition. In one voice they turn to Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Ya Rasulullah, Rasulullah, ud'u Allah alayhim. O Nabi of Allah, invoke the curses of Allah upon them. Make baddua for them. Allah must destroy them. Even in this condition, what does my Nabi do? He turns towards his Sahaba with tears in his eyes. And he says, Ama inni lam ub'ath la'anan. O my Sahaba, Allah has not sent me as one who will curse humanity. Allah has not sent me as one who will curse his ummah. Ama inni lam ubat la'anan innama bu'ithtu da'iyan wa rahmatan. Allah has sent me as a da'i. Allah has sent me as a da'i. And Allah has sent me as a rahmat and mercy for my ummah. Allahumma ahdi qawmi fa innahum la ya'lamun. O Allah, give hidayah to my ummah. O Allah, give hidayah to my ummah, because they don't know what they are doing. Such dard, such pain, such concern for humanity. Qurbani upon Qurbani. Hardship upon hardship. Persecution upon persecution. They would beat him. They would persecute him. They would insult him. The beloved around him, their lives were taken. Yet at night, Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam would get up and cry for the same people. Ya Allah, give them hidayat. Ya Allah, give them hidayat. Ya Allah, give them hidayat. O Allah, my ummah. O Allah, my ummah. O Allah, my ummah. Wallah, my respected brothers. Such was his dard. Such was his cry for humanity. A father in front of whom his entire family is burning in a house. How that father will cry. A mother whose child is dying in front of her only child. He's breathing his last. How that mother will cry. Wallah, by the qasam of my. By the qasam of my Allah. The cry of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam was more than that. His dard and his pain was more than that. His cry made the malaika cry. His cry caused the arsh of Allah to cry. Allah would send Jibreel, verse upon verse of the Quran, لَعَلَّكَ بَاخِعُ النَّفْسَكَ أَلَّا يَكُونُ مُؤْمِنِينَ.
لعلك باقي نفسك على آثارهم إن لم يؤمنوا بهذا الحديث أسفا. ما أنت عليهم بجبار، لست عليهم بوكيل، لست عليهم بمسيطر. ومن كفر فلا يحزنك كفره، فلا تذهب نفسك عليهم حسرات. Allah's قسم، no language can translate this. No language can translate the dard and the pain and the cry contained in this. Dard and the pain and the cry contained in this. فَلَا تَذْهَبْ نَفْسُكَ عَلَيْهِمْ حَسَرَاتْ. اے میرے حبیب، حسرت کرتے کرتے اپنے آپ کو نہ مٹا دے. Oh my Nabi, with your grief and your dard and your pain, don't destroy yourself. It's not your fault. Where is this cry today? Where is this dard today? Where is this concern today in the ummah? That day is coming tomorrow, my respected brothers. The clock of our life is ticking. Sahaba will come in that court. Someone with his hand cut off. Someone with his leg cut off. Someone with his nose cut off. Lawnuhu lawnu dam. Rihuhu rihu misk. The color will be the color of blood. The smell will be the smell of musk. And each one will be saying, Fika wa fi rasulik. Fika wa fi rasulik. For your sake and the sake of your rasul. My respected brothers, what have we prepared for that day? What have we prepared for that day? What is our excuse on that day? When our Nabi will ask us, the janazah of my sunnah was coming out of the homes. My ummah, like ants were going towards Jahannam. On one occasion he describes himself. He says there is a fire. The moths and butterflies are falling into the fire. I am saving my ummah. Anazikum anin nar. He says, I am holding you by your waist, pulling you away. Wantum taqahhamuna fiha. You are still getting away and falling into the fire. My respected brothers, if we have got some guarantee, if they have got some guarantee that you have another 10 years or 20 years or 30 years, wallah, my respected brothers, I'm not addressing you. But if we don't have any guarantee, and wallah, we don't have any guarantee, the clock of our life is ticking. This is the ummah of the last Nabi of Allah. This is the ummah of Khatamun Nabiyeen. Like Salah is an order of Allah. Like Zakat is an order of Allah. Like Hajj is an order. By the Qasam of my Allah, Dawat and Tabligh is an order of Allah. The pain, compassion, concern, rahmat and mercy of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam for every Jew, every Christian, every Mushrik, every human being on the surface of this earth. The worry, how that person can be saved from Jahannam and go to Jannah. This each one of us has received through the barakat of the khatm nubuwat of Janabi Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Prepare some excuse for that. My respected brothers, don't look left, don't look right. Don't look right. Don't be deceived by shaitan that you've got a lot of time. Now is the time to make decision. Who of us is ready? Stand up and give our names. Four months to go in the path of Allah. Four months, stand up, my respected brothers. Don't wait for others. Allah brought us to this Mubarak Ijtima. Now is the time to make decision with Allah. Stand up and give our names, my respected brothers.
4 months cash from now till me, in me. Starting May, for the month of April. 4 months cash. Stand up quickly, my brother. Stand up, inshallah. Allah.